गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिस नेक्स्ट ई सेशन ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी. टुडेज टॉपिक इज द लास्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम द प्रैक्टिकल्स ऑफ पैरासाइटोलॉजी. द टाइटल ऑफ द टॉपिक इज ब्लड एंड टिश्यू फ्लैजिलेट्स. सो दिस टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम द सेक्शन पैरासाइटोलॉजी. यू ऑलरेडी नो द बेसिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ पैरासाइट्स. So these parasites belong to the group of protozoa, and you know that protozoa have been classified into flagellates and non-flagellates. So today's parasites belong to the group of flagellates. The important examples are Leishmania and Trypanosoma. Rest of the parasites are mainly non-flagellates or aflagellates. Some of them are flagellates, but they do not infect the blood or tissue system. So one of the example is Giardia, which is the intestinal flagellates, and other example is Trichomonas. So today's topic is blood and tissue flagellates, Leishmania and Trypanosoma. These topics have already been covered in lectures. So at the end of the session, you shall be able to understand what are flagellates, which affect the blood and tissue, their general classification, their pathogenicity, that is the infective form, their life cycle, their vectors, the clinical features of the disease, and the laboratory diagnosis of the disease. So hemoflagellates of the medical importance belong to the phylum Euglenozoa. You don't have to remember all these names. The important genera, Trypanosoma and Leishmania, they belong to the family Trypanosomatidae. So these are the morphological forms which can be seen in both Trypanosoma as well as Leishmania. All the forms, all the morphological forms necessarily need not to be present at one given time or in one given species of the parasite. And the different morphological forms can be differentiated on the basis of the position of kinetoplast and origin of the flagellum. So you can see here the nucleus and the position of kinetoplast as well as the flagellum. So with respect to the position of kinetoplast and nucleus, these morphological forms can be differentiated. Three morphological forms are flagellated. One is a flagellate, it is called as amastigote. The rest of the forms are promastigote, epimastigote and tripomastigote. The name of the parasite has been given because of its resemblance to the whip, that is the so you should know the difference or the terms. You should know the terms vector-borne disease and zoonotic disease, because the diseases caused by today's parasites are examples of both vector-borne disease as well as zoonotic disease. So the major clinical significance having blood protozoa having major clinical significance include following genera: Trypanosoma, Leishmania, Plasmodium, Toxoplasma and Babesia. So these parasites affect the blood and cardiovascular system and some other parts of the body. That is, once they infect the CVS, they start colonizing the other parts of the body or other systems of the body as well, out of which the first two are flagellated and the rest are aflagellate. So Trypanosoma and Leishmania are the blood and tissue flagellates. So we will start with trypanosomes or trypanosoma. There are two important divisions or two important major examples of trypanosomes, which can be divided into African trypanosomes and American trypanosomes. So African trypanosomes are the Trypanosoma brucei rhodesiens, Trypanosoma brucei gambiens and Trypanosoma brucei brucei. So the last one is the cattle pathogen or animal pathogen principally. So it doesn't cause any human infections, but the first two Rhodesians and Gambians. So Rhodesians is East African trypanosome and Gambians is West African trypanosome. The disease caused by these parasite is known as sleeping sickness, or more correctly East African sleeping sickness and West African sleeping sickness. Second group, American trypanosomes, or the fly. So this is a vector borne disease, Cestet fly. The scientific name of the genus of the fly is Glossina. There are different species for East and West African trypanosomes. The infective form, that is the form which is injected by the Cestet fly in human beings, is metacyclic trypomastigotes. In the human body, the habitat of the parasite is connective tissue. It invades the lymph nodes through lymphatics, so the immune system is somewhat compromised. It then invades the bloodstream and finally localizes in the brain. So this is, you know, the parasites are not that common in India. Exception is Leishmania. Leishmania is very much common in all parts of India. But these parasites, they cause a significant problem in certain part of the world. So the life cycle of this parasite, Trypanosoma brucei, it passes its life cycle in two different hosts. Definitive host is man and domestic animals. The intermediate host is Cestet fly. So you should know what is the definitive host and what is intermediate host. This is another representation of the life cycle. The life cycle, the stages in the Cestet fly and the stages in the human beings. So always start the life cycle from the infective form, that is metacyclic trypomastigote form, that are injected by the Cestet fly in human beings. So these are some minor differences in the two different forms of Trypanosoma brucei, that is Gambians and Rhodesians. Note that the species of the vector is different. There are some other minor differences also, like virulence is less in Gambians as compared to Rhodesians. This is the fly or the vector responsible for transmission of this disease, Glossina. So because of the bite of this fly, the parasite gets transmitted from one person to other person. Now the disease, sleeping sickness, two variants, East African and West African sleeping sickness, but in principle the disease is same. First of all, at the site of bite, the patient will develop the trypanosomal chancre or the chancre. Stage 1 disease is without the CNS involvement. There is some asymptomatic period. Then febrile illness develops along with lymphadenopathy. It is called as winter bottom sign. And in stage 2, there is CNS invasion. So the parasite localizes in the brain, and here the patient starts suffering from actual sleeping sickness. The sleep pattern of the patient is disturbed. There is daytime somnolence and the patient is restless and insomniac at the time of nights. So because of the behavioral and personality changes, there is apathy, confusion, fatigue, loss of coordination in the patient. Now the laboratory diagnosis, that is the important part. So direct microscopy or the direct demonstration of the parasite can be done by serial blood sample examination or CSF examination or lymph node aspirate examination. So smears can be prepared with these fluids and they can be stained with various stains and observed under microscope. So trypomastigotes of the parasite may be demonstrated directly in the smears under microscope. antibody detection can be done from serum as well as CSF. Various antibody detection test can be done. Antigen can also be detected from serum as well as CSF. Molecular methods, that is the advanced methods like PCR, FISH, LAMP and real-time PCR. So these methods can be used for detection of the nucleic acid, DNA of the parasite. Then culture is very rarely used and used at only higher facilities or research laboratories. And animal inoculation can be done. The experimental animal used for this parasite is mice. So this is direct demonstration of the parasite. You can see the GIMSA stained blood smear, peripheral blood smear. So this is thin smear, and the second one, B image, is the thick smear. So here you can see the parasite, the flagellated form or trichomastigote. Trypanosoma cruzi, it is mainly present in the American countries like Brazil, Argentina, Venezuela. It is a zoonotic disease that you should know, having many animal reservoirs like dogs, cats, possums and rodents. So morphology, the invertebrate host, it exists mainly in two forms only, trypomastigote form and amastigote form. In insect vector, that is radiweed bug or triatomine bug, it exists in trypomastigote form as well as epimastigote form. So this is the morphological representation, diagrammatic representation of the different forms of the parasite. This is the life cycle. Vector is radiweed bug or triatomine bug, and the infective form is trypomastigote form. The portal of entry of the parasite is skin or conjunctiva. So this is the vector responsible for transmission of the disease, triatomine bug or radiweed bug. So this is pathogenesis and clinical features of the disease. Early stage disease consists of Shagoma and Romanus sign. So this is Romanus sign, unilateral swelling of the eyelids because of the presence of parasite at that particular inflamed site. Then acute Chagas disease and chronic Chagas disease. In chronic Chagas disease, there is involvement of cardiac complications and gastrointestinal complications. So this is Shagoma at the site of the bite of the parasite, and Romanus sign, that is unilateral swelling of the eyelids. These are some differences between acute and chronic Chagas disease. So various systems get involved in chronic form, that is the gastrointestinal system and cardiovascular system as well. The laboratory diagnosis can be again by direct demonstration of the trypomastigote forms in weight mounts or thick or thin smears of peripheral blood. Culture can be done in tripellate medium but very rarely used. Antibody detection and antigen detection are similar to Trypanosoma brucei. Molecular methods, again detection of the nucleic acid, DNA. Animal inoculation, same as in Trypanosoma brucei, mice can be used. Xenodiagnosis is another term where the vector, examination of the vector is done for diagnosis of disease in the patient. So the vector is made to have a meal on the suffering person, that is patient. And if demonstration of parasite can be done in the vector, that is in this case radiweed bug, then the confirmation of the diagnosis can be done. So these are some videos in which you can see the motile forms of the parasite in blood wet mount. So you can see the RBCs, presence of RBCs and the motile forms of the parasite. So here you can see these are all RBCs, blood cells, and here at the center you can see the trypomastigote form of the trypanosome. So this is fresh thin blood film with trypanosome swimming between the red blood cells. This is another picture. So here you can see multiple trypanosomes, motile forms. And this is another video. For the Chagas disease, where various stages of the parasites in human beings can be demonstrated. So here the parasite is having the meal. When the person is in sleep, after the injection of the parasite in the tissue or after taking the blood meal, the parasite defecates on the person's skin, and through the feces of the parasite, feces of the vector, the parasite gets lodged in the patient's skin and subcutaneous tissue. Then it invades the bloodstream and starts dividing. So the amastigote forms getting converted into trypomastigote forms and invading various organs of the body. Like in this case, the myocardium of the muscles of the heart. So this is the trypomastigote form getting lodged in the cardiac cells, getting converted into amastigote form and then dividing. Then again getting converted into trypomastigote forms, attaining the motility and getting recirculated. So these are various morphological forms of the parasite of Trypanosoma cruzi, trypomastigote forms in gym-sustained smear. These are the amastigote forms seen in HNE stained smear of heart tissue or cardiac cells. This is the fluorescent staining, and these are the trypomastigote forms or epimastigote forms in culture. In the second part, Leishmania, this parasite is more important as it is present in India. The disease caused by this parasite is called as Kala Azar. Other species of the Leishmania cause oriental sore and spondia. So visceral leishmaniasis or Kala Azar, the Indian form is present in human beings, whereas in other countries like Africa it is present in rodents, and Mediterranean countries it is present in canines. Cutaneous leishmaniasis, which is caused by three different species: Leishmania donovani, also called dermal leishmanoid; Leishmania brasiliensis causes spondia; and Leishmania tropica causes oriental sore. So Leishmania donovani is the important example of Leishmania which causes Kala Azar or visceral leishmaniasis in India. The principal states which are affected by this Kala Azar disease are Assam, Bengal, Bihar, Orissa, Madras and some other states. These are the morphological forms of the parasite, amastigote and promastigote form. So this one is flagellated, this one is aflagellated. Mode of transmission of the parasite is through sand fly. But there are some other methods, other modes by which the disease can get transmitted. So one is congenital, from mother to the baby, or through blood transfusion, or accidental inoculation of culture, that is laboratory culture. But these ways are very rare. Most common mode is through the bite of the sand fly. So these are the various stages of the parasite promastigote, how it gets lodged. So here sand fly which injects the promastigote forms of the parasite in human beings, and this is the life cycle. The incubation period for the disease varies between 3 to 6 months, but it may exceed up to years. The clinical features being pyrexia, which is the early symptom, but most prominent feature is splenic enlargement. That's why it is called as visceral leishmaniasis. The viscera or the internal organs of the body are affected. There is hepatomegaly as well, but the prominent enlargement is in the spleen. Lymphadenopathy is also there. So the lab diagnosis can be done by direct evidence, that is demonstration of the parasite in smears, or indirect evidence like blood count, serum test, which can be an aldehyde test, antimony test, or complement fixation test. These tests are very rarely used nowadays. Most common method is direct demonstration of the parasite, which can be done by examination of peripheral blood smear or blood culture. In triple N medium, the promastigote forms can be seen in blood culture, or biopsy material like biopsy from the lymph node, sternal or iliac crest, or from the spleen, where the amastigote forms of the parasite can be seen in direct smear, or promastigote forms in culture of the biopsy material. The cultivation is done in triple N medium. Triple N stands for Novy, McNeil and Nicol. These are the three scientists which developed the culture medium. Culture is incubated at 22 to 24 degrees Celsius. Amastigote forms get converted into promastigote forms in the culture, and they can be maintained in the tissue culture. Now these are some details about the Leishmania tropica and Leishmania brasiliensis causing spondia and oriental sore. So these are the LD bodies which can be demonstrated in the peripheral blood smear. So here you can see LD bodies, Leishmania donovani bodies, or amastigote forms of the parasite in peripheral blood smear. As there is compromise of the immune system is affected, patient suffers from other conditions like secondary infections, secondary bacterial infections and secondary parasitic or even fungal infections, and patient may land in the complications. So this is the cutaneous form of the disease caused by Leishmania. So that is all about today's topic. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.